Now we will start with the classification of vegetation. So following types of vegetation may be identified in our country. That is five types of vegetation. First, it is a tropical evergreen. Second is tropical deciduous. Third is tropical thorn forest and shrubs. Fourth are the montane forest. That is a forest lying at high altitudes. And fifth is the mangrove forest. Students should know the difference between the evergreen type of forest and the deciduous type of forest. Don't say that evergreen type of forest don't shed their leaves, but evergreen type of forest, they also shed their leaves, but they do not have a definite season for shedding their leaves, and they shed their leaves in a cyclical manner. So for the whole year around, the tree appears to be green. But in case of the deciduous type of forest, the trees shed their leaves, or they have a definite season for shedding their leaves, and all the leaves are shed at the same time, and thus the trees don't appear to be green. That is the major difference with all the basic difference between the evergreen type of forest and the deciduous type of forest. Now we'll study in detail what are the different features of such five type of forest. First we'll start with the tropical evergreen type of forest. Naturally they are evergreen, so they will require a high amount of seasonal or annual rainfall. Such forests flourish in the areas where the annual rainfall exceeds 200 centimeters and the average annual temperature is 25 degrees centigrade to 27 degrees centigrade. And the average annual humidity, it exceeds 77%. Such forests are very dense and composed of tall and medium-sized trees and shrubs, several climbers and epiphytes, all in luxuriant growth. They do not shed their leaves altogether annually. This we have already done. They are found in heavy rainfall areas of Western Ghats. Now the regions where the tropical evergreen forests are found. First is the heavy rainfall areas of the Western Ghats. This we will study in the chapter on climate. Why does that the Western Ghats receive heavy rainfall? Island group of Lakshadweep, Andaman and Nicobar, because they also receive heavy rainfall. Third is the upper part of Assam. This also we will study in the chapter on climate. That why Assam receives heavy rainfall. And fourth is the Tamil Nadu coast. Now we mark it in the map. This region, that is the region of the Western Ghats, which receives heavy rainfall. This is the eastern part. We have marked the Tamil Nadu coast. We have marked the upper part of Assam, which also receives heavy rainfall and thus has the tropical evergreen type of forest. And this eastern part also. That is some part, eastern part of Bihar, Jharkhand and Bengal. Basically, it is only the maximum part lies in Bengal. Only very limited places of Bihar and Jharkhand. So, we can say that it is in the parts of upper part of Assam, Bengal, Tamil Nadu coast, island group of Lakshadweep, Andaman, Nicobar and heavy rainfall areas of Western Ghats. The map also, while practicing, you should draw these graphs. So here we can write, this refers to the distribution of the tropical evergreen forest. Now there is no definite time, which we have already done. The commercially important type of trees of this region or the tropical evergreen are ebony, mahogany, rosewood, rubber, quincona. From quincona you might have studied in biology that we receive the drug for malaria from it, that is quinine. So we can write that the commercially important trees. You should remember the important trees of the region for the questions of match the following type. First we can write ebony. Second is mahogany. Third is rosewood. Fourth is rubber. Rubber is an important tree of this region, quincona, from which we receive the drug of malaria. The fauna or the animal kingdom, it includes some of the important ones. Elephants, monkey, lemur, deer. You can remember one or two examples. One horned rhinosaur in the jungle of Assam and West Bengal. It is an important characteristic feature of the region having tropical evergreen type of forest. So the distinguishing feature is one horned rhinoceros in the jungles of Assam and West Bengal. Now coming to the tropical deciduous type of forest, this was the classification, these were the characteristics of the tropical evergreen forest. Now we study the second type of forest in India, that is the tropical deciduous forest. You should remember that these are the most widespread or prominent forests of India, or we can tropical deciduous forest. These are also known as the monsoon forest. India has a monsoon type of climate, and these are the predominantly characteristic features of the type of vegetation found in India. That is why they are also known as the monsoon forest. Mark is very important for examination point of view. These are found in region having rainfall between 70 centimeters to 100 centimeters. As they are deciduous, the trees of such forest type shed their leaves for about 6 to 8 weeks in dry summer. They are divided into two types on the basis of availability of water. First being the moist deciduous and the second being the dry deciduous. First we will study the characteristic feature of the moist deciduous type. These are found in regions having rainfall between 200 centimeters and 100 centimeters. The mean annual temperature in this region is around 26 degrees centigrade to 27 degrees centigrade, and the percentage of humidity ranges from 60% to 80%. The region where we find the moist deciduous type of forests are basically the northeastern states, foothills of the Himalayas. You should remember the region, or you can directly learn it from the map of the distribution of various type of vegetation. Third region being the Jharkhand. Fourth being West Odisha. Chhattisgarh. These are the just the nearby regions, and on the eastern slopes of the Western Ghat. On the western slopes, we have studied the evergreen type of forest. On the eastern slope, we are studying the deciduous type of forest. This we will study in the chapter on climate, where there is a difference in rainfall on the western side and the eastern side. You might be having a rough idea about the windward side and the leeward side of mountain. The same reason applies over here. So now we can also write the eastern slopes of the Western Ghats. This was the moist deciduous type of forest. An important feature is that the subsoil water in these regions is not enough to allow the trees to keep their leaves all the year around. These forests are the most important forests yielding commercial timber and various other products of high value. The most predominant species of flora or the type of tree, that is teak. It is very important to remember that teak is a characteristic type of tree of the tropical deciduous type of forest. And tropical deciduous type of forests are most predominant in distribution in the Indian subcontinent suiting to its climatic conditions. Other species being bamboo, saal, shisham, sandalwood, khair, kusum, arjun, mulberry. So other important species. Bamboo, saal. Other important species are bamboo, saal, shisham, sandalwood, khair, kusum, arjun, mulberry. They provide timber as well as they have the medicinal properties also. This was about the moist deciduous type of forest. Now we'll study the dry deciduous type of forest. These are found in areas having rainfall between 100 cm and 70 cm. So we can write they are found in region having rainfall between 100 centimeters and 70 centimeters. So dry deciduous type of forest, we have seen that they are found in areas having rainfall between 100 centimeters and 70 centimeters. The region where in India we find the dry deciduous type of forests are, these forests are found in the rainier parts of the peninsula, that of peninsula plateau and the plains of Bihar and UP. Because whole of the peninsula plateau does not receive an abundant amount of rainfall. So those part of the peninsula which receives a sufficient amount of rainfall and the plains of Bihar and UP are the region where we find the dry deciduous type of forest. So we can write they are found in the rainier parts of the peninsula and the plains of Bihar and UP. Important trees of this region or important trees of this area also includes teak, sal, peepal and neem. These are the important species. You can remember, if you want to write, you can write others also. Now the large tract of these forest areas have been cleared for agricultural purposes. Lion, tiger, pig, bear and elephant are the common animals found in this region. So now we will study on the map the distribution of these forests. Now on the map we'll mark the region in which we find the tropical deciduous type of forest. As I have already said, these are the most predominant type of forest. So maximum part of India has such type of forest. So we'll start drawing it right from here. This pink part, it represents the distribution of the tropical deciduous type of forest. This is covering the maximum area. So now on this, you can see that it covers the region of Bihar, UP, the plateau region, South part, there in the Western Ghats. You can see it on the eastern slopes of the Western Ghats. Other region being Central India, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, some part of Orissa, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, some part of Karnataka, southern part and or the maximum part of Bihar, Jharkhand, eastern part of UP, bearing the Uttaranchal region. So this represents the distribution of the tropical deciduous type of forest. So here we can draw another block representing the distribution of tropical deciduous type of forest. You need not mark it separately as dry deciduous or moist deciduous. At your level you can draw it just for the tropical deciduous type of forest on the whole. Now we will study the thorn forest and the scrubs. This is the third part. We have done tropical evergreen, we have done tropical deciduous. Now we come to thorn forest and scrubs. These are found in the regions with less than 70 centimeters of rainfall. So we can write here that these are found in the regions having rainfall less than 70 centimeters. The region where we find these types are the northwestern part of country, including the semi-arid areas of Gujarat, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, UP and Haryana. As the rainy season is short and the amount of rainfall is small, so the trees have adaptation to survive in the conditions of scarcity of rainfall. Trees have long roots penetrating deep into the soil in order to get moisture. The stems are succulent to conserve water, leaves are mostly thick and small to minimize evaporation. They also have sunken stromata to reduce transpiration. You will study in your bio chapters what are stromatas. Stromatas are the organs of the leaves or the parts which help in the transpiration. So in this case, they have the sunken stromata to avoid the water loss by transpiration. Common species being the acacia, babool, cacti, khejra. So we can write here the common species. Babool, cacti, khejra, aak and neem. These forests give way to thorn forests and scrubs in arid areas. The common animals being rat, mice, rabbits, wolf, wild ass, horses, camel, etc. So now as a synopsis, we can write down the characteristic features We can write that plants have adaptation to survive in the conditions of scarcity of rainfall. For example, they have deep penetrating roots, they have short and thick leaves to minimize evaporation, and they have the sunken stomata. And the region where we find such type northwest part of the country, including the semi-arid area of Gujarat, Rajasthan, MP, Chhattisgarh, Uttar Pradesh, and Haryana. Now you should be able to mark on the map these regions. So now we mark them on the map. This blue shade, you can remember it as the region where we find the thorn forest and the scrubs covering the region of Rajasthan, Gujarat, western part of Madhya Pradesh, some part of Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, some part of Uttar Pradesh, and some part of Haryana. So now here we can write thorn forest and scrub. Now we study the montane forest, that is the fourth type. Montane here refers to mountain. And at places of high altitude where we find a decrease in temperature with increasing altitude, this leads to change in vegetation. So we see a transformation in vegetation from tropical type to the tundra type. In this, we further study as wet temperate type of forest, temperate forest, and we also study the common alpine vegetation. So these are the region at high altitudes. And here we find a transformation from tropical type of vegetation to the tundra type. In this we further study first the wet temperate type of forest. These are found between a height of 1000 and 2000 meters, that is the altitude. Important trees are the evergreen broadleaf trees, for example oak and chestnut. These are the important species of plant characteristic of this type of vegetation. Further, we study the temperate type of forest. These are found at altitude between 1500 meters to 3000 meters. Important being, in this we find the coniferous trees, for example pine, deodar, silver fir, spruce and cedar. These are the coniferous trees or the cone bearing trees characteristic of these type of forests. At higher elevation, temperate grasslands are common, that is as we move from the wet temperate type of forest to temperate type of forest. So at the altitude of above 3000 meters, we find the temperate grasslands. At an altitude of above 3600 meters, temperate forests and grasslands give way to the alpine type of vegetation, and common trees of this also being the silver fir, junipers, pines and birches. So we can write here that at an altitude above 3600 meters, temperate forests and grasslands, they give way to the alpine vegetation. Important trees of this being the silver fir, junipers, and birches. These are the major coniferous trees. Further near the snow line, the trees get progressively stunted, that is shorter in length or lower growth, and ultimately through shrubs and scrubs they merge into the alpine grasslands. These grasslands are used extensively for grazing by nomadic tribes like the Gujars and the Bakarwals. It is important to remember the use of the alpine type of grasslands. These are used extensively for grazing by nomadic tribes. Further high, mosses and lichens form the part of the tundra vegetation. You might have heard about the litmus. Litmus solution, it is obtained from the extract of lichen. So lichens, these are also a part of the tundra vegetation. These are the various characteristics of the montane type of vegetation, in which we find the mix of forests, that is trees, stunted growth, and finally to grassland. You can remember some of the animals like Kashmir stag, Tibetan antelope, rare red panda, sheep, goats, which have thick hair. Generally, to survive the extreme cold conditions, there is a predominance of fur-bearing animals. So you can write here the examples of the fur-bearing animals. Example, the Kashmir stag, Tibetan antelope, red panda. You should remember these type of animals. So now we mark it on the map, the region where we find the montane type of forest. It is very obvious they are found at high altitudes. So now we mark the montane type of forest. Generally we mark it in the northern part of India, that is this region. So in the map you can see the montane type of forest, extreme north, that is in Jammu Kashmir, parts of Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal and Sikkim. And in the further east you can see the parts of Arunachal Pradesh, northern part of some part of Assam, in which we find the montane type of forest. From the map, it is easier to remember the distribution, whether it is of the tropical evergreen, tropical deciduous, thorn forest or the montane type of forest. It is very easy to remember. Montane forest, they will generally lie at high altitudes. Tropical evergreen, they will lie in the region receiving heavy rainfall. So when you study the chapter on climate, it will be much easier to remember which are the regions in India receiving heavy rainfall, generally the eastern part of India and the parts of Western Ghats or the western slopes of the Western Ghats. Tropical deciduous, this is the most predominant type of vegetation in India. And thorn forests and scrub, they will definitely lie in the dry parts of India. So a belt from western Rajasthan to Gujarat, because it receives very less amount of rainfall. Now the last, that is the mangrove type of forest. The characteristic feature are, these are the tidal forests. Naturally, they are found near the coast, which receives the tidal waters. You all know that we have the tides from the because of the gravitation pull of the moon and the sun exerted on the surface of the earth, due to which we have the occurrence of tides, both high tide and the low tide. So mangrove forests, these are the tidal forests. They are found near the coast. These are the tidal forests. They are found near the coast. Due to the effect of the tide, mud and silt gets accumulated on such coasts. These forests are found in the thickest on the western coast at a few places, but on the eastern coast they form a fairly continuous fringe along the delta of Ganga, Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. You might have studied this on the chapter on drainage, that a lot of amount of silt, it is brought about by rivers like Ganga, Mahanadi, Godavari, Brahmaputra, and they form the features of deposition known as the delta. Brahmaputra, we have done that it forms the largest riverine island, that is Majoli. Similarly, near West Bengal, Ganga deposits a huge amount of silt, which leads to the formation of delta. So we can again say that these forests are found in the thickest on the western coast at a few places, but on the eastern coast they form a continuous fringe along the delta of Ganga, Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. They are found in the densest forms in the Sundarban, in the Ganga Delta, where the predominant species like the Sundari tree occurs, and it is because of the predominance of the Sundari tree that this region is known as the Sundarban Delta. Other trees being the palm, coconut, kevra, agar found in the deltaic region. It is important to remember that Royal Bengal Tiger, it is found in these forests. So one should remember, if you are asked the type of forest or give a classification or description of the forest which is the natural habitat or the home of the Royal Bengal Tiger, then you should remember it is the mangrove forest. So we can write the features of the mangrove forest. Mangrove forest, they form a continuous ridge or they form a continuous fringe on the eastern coast of India along the deltas of Ganga, Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. They are found in a dense form in the Sundarban Delta. The important species and major one being the Sundari tree. Other trees being the palm, coconut, kevra, agar. These are some of the species of the mangrove forest. And one of the major important feature is that the Royal Bengal Tiger, it is found in these forests. So this was the major classification of type of the forest found in India with flora and fauna. Now talking about the fauna in general for India as a whole, having a relative position to the world distribution of animals, India has more than 89,000 of animal species with more than 1200 species of birds. These account for 13% of the world's total. If you are asked a question on the distribution of fauna in India, you should start with the introduction as far as the global level is concerned or comparison of India. That is these data that India has more than 89,000 of animal species with more than 1200 species of birds and which account for the 13% of the world's total. India also shares between 5 and 8% of the world's amphibians, reptiles and mammals. Elephants, these are the most majestic animals among the mammals found in Assam, Karnataka and Kerala. The swampy and marshy lands of Assam and West Bengal are famous for one-horned rhinoceros. We have done here Royal Bengal Tiger. Now in case of one-horned rhinoceros, we are saying that the swampy and marshy lands of Assam and West Bengal, they are famous for one-horned rhinoceros. Wild ass and camels, they are found in dry region of Rann of Kutch in Gujarat and Thar Desert of Rajasthan respectively. So now on the map, we'll mark the mangrove forest. We'll mark it more on the eastern side. The gaps which are remaining, it refers to the mangrove type of forest. So here, this represents a zone. This eastern part, coastal part, we have said that they receive the tidal waters. So these represents the zone of the where we find the mangrove type of forest. The delta region or the Sundarbans, these are the major regions in which we find the mangrove type of forest. So now you can have a very clear relative position of the various type of forest, whether it is tropical evergreen, tropical deciduous, thorn forest, the mountain forest and the mangrove forest. Instead of remembering as per the classification what we have done in theory, directly from the map you can remember the distribution of the places as per the vegetation.